Whether you're a fan of the Souls series or not, it is undeniable that Dark Souls 1 is one of the best RPGs ever made and influenced countless games since its initial release back in 2011. Bloodborne and Dark Souls 3 were developed for current-gen consoles from the get-go, and even Dark Souls 2, the black sheep of the Souls family, received a remastered version. So it was only a matter of time until what many regard as the best game in the series received the same treatment. Unfortunately, after my initial excitement for Dark Souls Remastered, disappointment followed swiftly. More and more footage, as well as details regarding the specific improvements and changes, have surfaced throughout the last couple of months. And I gotta say, all in all, Dark Souls Remastered seems like a huge missed opportunity. In a best case scenario, a remastered version of a beloved classic should offer enough incentive to convince both people who already played the original and people who are newcomers that the remaster is a good investment. If you either never played a Souls game but are interested to give it a try, or already enjoyed other entries of the series but haven't come around to play Dark Souls 1 yet, then Dark Souls Remastered represents a perfect investment. You can get your hands on the polished version of one of the best games in video game history for a mere 40 bucks. In that regard, Dark Souls Remastered is just fine. Even more, it's a fantastic gateway drug for everyone who wants to enter the Souls franchise. On the flip side, longtime fans of the series, including myself, see little to no reason to pay the absurd amount of $40 for minor changes PC mods already implemented years ago. Granted, console players were still stuck with the last-gen console version. However, that doesn't excuse a game promising to deliver but the bare minimum in order to slap the label Remastered on a box. What exactly is Dark Souls Remastered actually changing? And why do I consider it to be a missed opportunity? Let's have a look at the improvements which are supposed to justify the $40 price tag. The first major change is a no-brainer. Frame rate has been increased to 60 FPS and the resolution has been increased to 1080p. Especially the higher frame rate is quite a benefit in a game that leans so heavily on its intricate combat system. Apparently, Blighttown's unbearable frame rate issues have finally been resolved. What else do we have? Online player capacity has been increased from 4 to 6 and password matchmaking is available. Apart from a few graphical tweaks, that's pretty much it. Don't get me wrong, I'm not saying these changes aren't welcome. What I'm saying is that such minimal changes are not enough to justify a $40 purchase, at least not for people who already own a copy of Dark Souls. Okay, so if you are not satisfied with the result, what should they have done differently, you might ask? Isn't the whole point of a remaster to keep the game intact exactly as it was and only improve it visually? Well, first of all, the graphical improvements are inconsistent and definitely not on par with the better remastered versions I've seen. Take Bluepoint's work on the Uncharted trilogy as an example. Secondly, two fucking words. Lost Izalith. Dark Souls isn't regarded as one of the best RPGs of all time for no reason. In terms of level design, combat system, and art direction, this game was groundbreaking. However, even a game like Dark Souls has its weak points. Lost Izalith is the ultimate low point. This area has been a thorn in the Souls community's flesh for far too long. It's hard to believe that the same people who are responsible for the genius boss and level design in areas like Undead Burg, Zen's Fortress, or Anor Londo are the same people who created the abomination that is Lost Izalith. One awfully designed boss chases the next, resulting in some of the worst boss battles in the series. Bad of Chaos isn't just horrible for Souls standards, it's shitty boss design even compared to most other games out there. And don't get me started on the level design. Lost Izalith goes against the very core concept that makes Dark Souls level design so engaging in the first place. Verticality continuity and intertwining pathways are nowhere to be found. Instead, this area consists of linear, vast open areas, completely empty and a chore to walk through. Blighttown may be one of the most hated areas in the Souls franchise, but once the framerate issues are fixed, Blighttown nonetheless is as intricately constructed as the rest of the game. It's one of the first major tests. Blighttown is hated because it's difficult. However, it isn't badly designed. Lost Eitherleth is hated because we have to deal with actual bad game design. Miyazaki himself describes the area as his greatest regret. In short, Miyazaki himself despises Lost Eitherleth, and so does the vast majority of players. For that reason, Dark Souls Remastered represents a huge missed opportunity. Finally, after 7 years, the one blatantly obvious weak spot of an otherwise brilliantly designed masterpiece could have been fixed once and for all. I'm aware of the fact that From Software isn't developing Dark Souls Remastered, it's being handled by a separate company. But all it would take to fix the one glaring issue of Dark Souls 1 are 3 revamped bosses and improved level design. Maybe we are entering remake territory instead of remaster territory by then. And yes, I'm sure From Software has plenty of work already. They are working on several games, one of which is Shadows Die Twice. Still, I can't help but feel disappointed. I was under the impression Miyazaki would jump at the chance to put the finishing touches on the game that established FromSoft as a household name and made him into one of the most respected developers in the games industry. As I already said, maybe he wanted to, but the immense amount of work simply didn't allow it. Despite all that, one of the greatest benefits Dark Souls Remastered offers is a short burst of reinvigorated excitement for a game that changed the industry more than 7 years ago. Once Dark Souls 1 gets released, at least for a few weeks, the entire video game world will be reminded of the genius artistic endeavor that is Dark Souls 1. For a short period, the Souls community is handed the perfect excuse to revel in the past. Full servers and an overall presence of the game on YouTube are sure to bring back great memories. Dark Souls will be a main talking point again, if only for a limited amount of time. Apart from that, it's the perfect appetizer for the imminent Shadows Die Twice reveal in 3 weeks' time. Bloodborne 2 or something entirely new, as long as From Software's name is attached to the project, I'm in. As always, thank you guys a lot for watching. Please leave behind a like and subscribe to my channel if you haven't done so already. Do you think I'm too harsh on Dark Souls Remastered, or are my complaints reasonable? And what were you hoping to see? Share your opinion in the comment section below.